Good evening. Welcome to the commencement exercises for the class of 2022. Please rise for the processional.
Would you please bow your heads as we pray? Dear Lord, we thank you for a beautiful day today, like today, and we thank you for everyone getting here safely to show their love and support to all of my fellow classmates. And we thank you for another academic year that has been full of laughs, cries, and memories that we will hold dear to us for the rest of our lives. As we embark on our new beginnings, we ask you to lead us young men and women to live lives full of your grace and be the new leaders of our society. And as we begin living in the real world, I ask you to grant each and every one of us with solace and strength. For we know not what your plans are for us. I ask you that you guide us through the adversities we will have to overcome in the near future. May your integrity be a gift to the world, and may the Spirit of God be with you always. In Jesus' name, amen.
You may be seated. Good evening. I am Kristen Wilson, class of 22, class president. It is my honor to welcome you to the graduation ceremony at Isabella High School. Because of this school, we have made the most unforgettable moments of our lives. I am filled with excitement and anticipation as the next stage in my life is about to begin. But without the support from our parents, grandparents, teachers, administration, we would not be here today. Thank you for watching us grow and guiding us through the years. At this time, let me introduce Superintendent Jason Griffin to the podium.
Good evening. What a beautiful afternoon. Mr. Porter always calls this God's country, and so many of you call it the same thing, and it is truly beautiful here. I always enjoy being here and looking out over the, I'm going to use a big word, the veranda, and seeing the skyline back there. It's a beautiful place to be. So tonight, congratulations to the class of 2022. You have made it, and you look good. I mean, you look real good. Y'all look sharp. You've all taken baths, and you got everything like you like it, so congratulations. You have made it. You should be proud of this great accomplishment. Years of hard work and effort have brought you to today's celebration. Many people have helped you along the way, and if you look behind you, you see a lot of people that love and care for you. Isabella truly loves their students and their community. Whether that be a parent, guardian, grandparent, aunt, uncle, or any other family member or friend, they have supported you. Congratulations to you as well as you celebrate tonight with your loved one. A thank you for your teachers, administrators, support staff, and coaches or sponsors is also deserved. Each of you receives support and encouragement from some of those individuals, and those will be memories that you'll never forget. Therefore, congratulations to everyone here tonight as we honor our graduates. The goal of education is to prepare you for life. Today is the moment you become a high school graduate and go out into the world. We know that you are prepared for whatever path lies ahead for you, whether that be work, college, career technical school, or the military is in your future. What an exciting time filled with opportunity. I know whatever path you choose that you will be successful. I challenge you to use the education you have achieved to go out into the world and make a difference. You'll always be welcome back in Chilton County and specifically here at Isabella High School, as you will always be a Mustang. We look forward to seeing all the great things you accomplish in life. We are proud of you and thank you for allowing us to celebrate with you today. And so before I do this last part, I speak at all six of the high schools every year, and I always like to see who cheers the loudest. So Saturday, Jemison was pretty loud, and I expect Isabella to be just as loud. So here we go. Congratulations again to the class of 2022, and as always, go Mustangs!
Seniors, parents, faculty, Superintendent Jason Griffin, and other honored guests, as well as those that are joining us this evening on our school's YouTube site through live streaming, I'd like to welcome each one of you here tonight to Bill Neighbors Stadium and Isabella High School campus to help us celebrate the graduation ceremonies for the class of 2022. And yes, I did say to celebrate. This class, during their high school years, have faced many unprecedented and trying times. Yet while we acknowledge all the adversities that this group has had to overcome, through it all, this group has continued to make great things happen. So we're here tonight not to focus on those adversities, but rather we're here tonight to celebrate the greatness of the class of 2022. and the great things that these young men and women have accomplished during their tenure here at Isabella High School, culminating with tonight's graduation ceremonies. First of all, let me say how proud I am to be the principal here at Isabella and how privileged I feel to have had the opportunity to work with each one of these young men and women on a daily basis during the past 13 years. This is a group that I've gotten to know very well and a group that will always hold a special place and an unforgettable place in my heart. And yes, we do say that about just about every group. But each group that comes through does hold a special place in my heart. However, this group, more so than most, hold a truly special place in my heart. During these past 13 years, I've watched them as they move through elementary, kindergarten graduation, sixth grade graduation, and moved into high school, junior high, started out in the auditorium in the very back as freshmen, and moved forward each year, culminating this year, finally, as seniors. I've watched them grow and mature into a well-rounded group of young men and women, energetic, fun-loving group that will greatly be missed. When I think about each group, I try to think, what makes this group special? What makes this group stand out from the rest? As I reflected upon this group for this senior class, the word that kept coming to my mind and the word that I kept hearing over and over was the word accomplished. As I mentioned at senior night, this is one of our smaller graduating classes. However, they're one of our most accomplished groups, a truly well-rounded group, both in and out of the classroom. And there's no more compelling evidence of this than the numerous scholarships and awards that were presented on senior night, where in excess of $1 million of scholarships was presented. I think we should give them a big hand for that. Years from now, when I think back on this group, what will come to my mind is the many accomplishments of our first million-dollar class, the class of 2022. Scholarships awarded included full-ride academic scholarships, full-ride athletic scholarships, military scholarships, vocational scholarships, as well as many other smaller scholarships and awards. These accomplishments in and of themselves speak volumes about the commitment, the dedication, and the plain old hard work that this class has put into their high school education. And I would like to take the opportunity at this time to thank each person that played a part in helping this class and each individual to reach the milestone that they have attained. I'm assured that I speak for each of you, and I speak for all of us, as I take this opportunity to express to the class of 2022 how proud we are of what you've accomplished, what you've become, and the direction in which you're headed. Many of you have chosen to further your academic or athletic careers by attending a college or university. And I want you to know how proud we are of the choices that you've made. Some have chosen to join the military, and I want you to know how proud we are of you. I can think of no more honorable career than serving one's country. Many others have chosen technical or vocational careers as your path of choice. Some of them have dedicated themselves to their trade, and come August, will likely be bringing home more money than I make. So seniors, I want each and every one of you to know that regardless of whatever career path you've chosen and whatever you endeavor to become, we want each and every one of you to know how proud we are of you and what you've accomplished. So many have had to overcome so much. And I must admit that there have been times when I wondered if some of you were going to make it. And some didn't. But you, through your perseverance, your dedication, and your hard work, you made it. As you move forward beyond tonight, I would like to leave you with this quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson that says, "Dare to live the life that you have dreamed. Go forward and make your dreams come true." If I could offer you as the graduating class of 2022 any advice, it would be this. First, to set your goals high and work hard to achieve them. No goal is too high. And second, remember anything worth having is worth working for. Life does not always go as expected, and these recent times are evidence of that. Life is filled with adversity, as many of you have already experienced. There are going to be times when you have setbacks, and there are going to be times when you face stumbling blocks. And how well you persevere and battle through these will determine how successful you become. Those who quit, those who look for the quick fix or the shortcut will ultimately underachieve. But those who stay the course and do the right thing will ultimately succeed. There's a verse in Galatians that I love to quote, and it says, "God will not be mocked. That which you sow, so shall you reap." And I know it's hard sometimes when you look around and see others sowing so little and yet seemingly reaping so much. However, theirs is like the house built on the sand. It's destined to fall. Those who stay the course and do the right thing will ultimately succeed. Life is truly a journey. It's a marathon and not a sprint. So tonight, as you begin that next stage of life, no matter what career path you've chosen or what you endeavor to become, the ultimate choice is yours. And I challenge each of you, set your goals high and work hard to achieve them. William Arthur Ward said, "If you can imagine it, you can achieve it. If you can dream it, you can become it." So for the class of 2022, the million-dollar class, go forward, live the life that you have dreamed for yourself, and make each day a great day to be a Mustang. I love each one of you and wish each one of you the best of luck. At this time, we're going to ask our assistant principal, Mr. Chris Turner, if he would to come to the podium. He's going to introduce our speakers for tonight, our salutatorians and our valedictorians.
Good evening. I'm very thankful for being a part of the Mustang family and have enjoyed the experience of getting to know these outstanding group of students we have here before us. Seniors, as you prepare to enter into adulthood and move beyond the IHS campus, I want to wish each and every one of you my best hopes and wishes that the choices you have made and will continue to make will lead to a very productive and fulfilling life. Tonight, it is my honor to introduce the Isabella High School's valedictorians and salutatorians for the graduating class of 2022. The students who have earned these distinguished titles have a proven academic record of excellence and have shown exceptional work ethic throughout their high school years. In order to receive the recognition of the title valedictorian, the students must attain a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 0.25. The salutatorian is the student that had the next highest grade point average, but just under that threshold. Tonight we have two students that have tied for salutatorian. We will begin our salutatorian speeches with Destiny Brasher, who will be followed by Cadence Headley. Please join me in congratulating them for their big accomplishments.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us, the graduating class of 2022. My name is Destiny Brasher, and I am proud to be a salutatorian. I would like to say a big thank you to our families and teachers who have helped us get this far in our educational journey. Throughout this journey, our class has faced many triumphs and challenges. Embrace the triumphs and face the challenges head on. There are many steps in life. Together we have taken the big steps, the small steps, and even the messy steps. Each one that was taken was a sign of courage and strength. These steps have helped us grow and taught us valuable lessons. Life is a beautiful gift, and we all have the chance to make and leave something good in this world. Classmates, when you continue to make your imprint on this world, I hope that you do it with good, because there is only moving forward, and the footprints left behind represent your story. I am so proud to say that we've made it. Just think of all the things that have brought us up to this moment. So many memories have been made along the way, and I would like to wish my classmates a healthy and happy journey for whatever they may choose today and after today in their lives. Our paths may never cross again, but I will forever cherish the memories we created, whether they were happy or sad. When I look back at these memories, they're all steps we were taking together. Thank you all, and happy graduation to the class of 2022. Forever and always, it's a great day to be a Mustang.
Good evening. My name is Cadence Headley. It is my honor to be standing here as salutatorian of the class of 2022. The past 13 years I have spent with my class has truly been unforgettable. There definitely has been some ups and downs, but the good times I've had will always overshadow the drama that went on. There are so many memories I can share from high school, like winning the Isabella three times, our first ever Powderpuff game, used to sing Take Me Home Country Roads in Miss Green's class, senior prom and senior homecoming, checking out to go get food, Miss Lecoy's class, and by the way, Miss Lecoy, I never touched the thermostat, and of course, all the sporting events. I know there are many more great memories I could add, but I'll cherish them forever. The last 13 years I have been interesting to say the least, but I can honestly say I wouldn't have changed a thing. We may all say we hate high school and we are so ready to graduate and get out of here, but the truth is, nothing is really gonna be the same. We will miss each other and all the fun we had, the school events, and even the teachers. I would like to say thank you to all the faculty and staff here at Isabella, and I feel it is safe to say that I speak on behalf of the whole graduating class of 2022 in thanking you for all your support and efforts that you have invested in us to this day. I wanted to give a huge thank you to my mom and dad for always loving me and supporting me in everything I do and pushing me to be the best I can be no matter what. Thank you to the rest of my family and friends for all the love and support you have shown. I would also like to take this opportunity to acknowledge a very influential woman who left such an impact on a lot of people. Mrs. Washington held the title of a fourth grade teacher, but she was so much more than that. She had the biggest heart, a contagious laugh, and always knew how to make someone smile. I have so many great memories with her, one being Motown. That was my favorite thing to watch and even be a part of. I'm so thankful I had her not only as my teacher, but a friend. She showed us commitment, compassion, kindness, as well as strength and courage. Although she is not here with us today, I know that she is looking down on all of us and is so proud of everything we have accomplished. Finally, to the class of 2022, congratulations, we made it. We never thought this day would come, but here we are. It seems like it was just yesterday when we began high school in seventh grade and all we wanted to do was graduate. The years have flown by, especially our senior year, because it seems like we should just be starting. We have come a long way as a class, and I'm thankful I got to know each one of you and make some great memories over the years. I want to wish you all a good luck in this next chapter of life and hope you exceed beyond all your expectations. Thank you.
Next, we'll have speeches from Isabella High School's valedictorians. First, we will hear from Arley Aguilera, followed by Alexandra Bringas Garcia. Daniel Gilliland will go third. And lastly, we will hear a speech by Braxton Vinson. You students have made your parents, teachers, and community proud. Please join me in celebrating Isabella's valedictorians. Y'all just come up one at a time.
Hello, everyone. I am Arley Aguilera. First, I would like to thank my family and God for helping me and motivating me throughout all these years. Second, I would like to thank our teachers and staff for helping us and preparing us all these years for this day and our future. Lastly, I want to thank y'all, my classmates, for this amazing last 13 years of my life. We have made a lot of great memories that I'm sure we will remember forever. We have laughed a lot together, and we have argued a lot together. But all of this has just brought us closer. After graduation, some of us might never see each other again, while others might see each other regularly. Whatever path you have chosen, whether that is to go to college or start working after high school, I wish you the best of luck. I hope you guys achieve your dreams. Who knows? Maybe one day I'll end up teaching your kids. Goodbye for now, and I'll miss all of you. Thank you once again. I couldn't have asked for a better class. Class of 22, congrats. We did it.
First and foremost, I would like to thank God for getting us to this day as we are here to celebrate such a huge milestone for the class of 2022. I'm gonna keep this speech short and simple because my classmates asked me to, so here I go. I would like to thank my parents for supporting me always and helping me get to this point. I would not be here if it wasn't for them and them pushing me to always try my hardest. Second, I would like to thank some of my teachers, Ms. Arnold, Ms. Higgins, Ms. Mims, Mama Nelly, Mrs. Mott, and Ms. Copenhaver, who is no longer at Isabella, but I will always cherish her. Thank you for having that teacher-student bond with me and making my high school years something to remember. I will definitely miss you, and I hope to see y'all around Walmart or something. Lastly, I would like to thank my classmates. For the past 13 years, well, for some, we have created many, many memories that I will forever cherish. Amongst some of these exciting memories are Braxton almost blowing up Ms. Copenhaver's room, winning the Isabella 3 years in a row, drama class, and all the drama that went on in Mama Nelly's room, which Braxton and Luca always start. So thank you for being family and just being who you are. I hope each one of you succeeds in life and accomplish your goals. And with that, I end my valedictorian speech. Class of 2022, I love you forever.
Good evening, everyone. Sorry in advance to class of 2022. This is not short and sweet, but I will do the best that I can. Wow, I cannot believe that at this moment in time has finally arrived. Class of 2022, look how far we've come. When thinking about our journey, I couldn't help but think that life is like the road you travel on. Right now, we are nearing the exit, the off-ramp, so to speak, that we will use to a new intersection. Like, we've been traveling on this road for over 70% of our lives so far. 13 years to be exact. Sometimes the road has been a little bumpy. We've hit a few potholes along the way. This is Chilton County. But we have all learned to dodge a few obstacles as we have grown and matured into our ability to navigate through classes, sports, work, and so much more. There have been times when we just put on the cruise control. You know, times like pep rallies, homecoming festivities, prom, and just hanging out with friends. As we approach this new fork in the road, we must take time to slow down and reflect on where we have been and where we are going. However, no one really wants to slow down. As a matter of fact, all of my classmates just want these speeches to be over, and most of them don't care. Many don't want a yield sign, but a green light to our diplomas. However, a very valuable teacher of mine, Miss Tammy Perrette, during a mentoring Wednesday lesson, once shared with me a great piece of advice. She told me that life is full of actions and consequences, but how a person chooses to react is totally in her own control. Her favorite example was about road rage. How fitting. Have you ever had someone slow down in front of you when you were trying to get somewhere? She would often tell us. How many of us just want to blow the horn, ride their bumper, or pass them regardless if it is safe? Well, Miss Perrette said that although we cannot control the other driver's actions, we can choose how we choose to react to it. Many times we might want to consider why we are being made to slow down. Maybe it's God's plan to protect us from harm that is further up the road. Please remember that navigating the real world may present its own challenges as we go our separate ways after tonight. However, we can choose to be proactive instead of reactive, and be thankful when God provides us with an opportunity to take a detour, because his plans always work out better than our own. You see, with God as our co-pilot, we will never be lost. In addition to God, we have had many co-pilots, passengers, and other road or pit crew who have helped us better than any GPS to navigate through our educational career in life. First, I want to thank my grandparents, especially my grandmother, because not only did she feed me lunch, homemade lunch, several days a week, she also taught me Algebra 2 and helped me pass my high school math classes. Yes, my grandmother knows how to teach high school math, and I am hoping she is planning on continuing to ride to college with me for future math classes too. Love you, Grandmother. Grandfather, thank you for always keeping things real and for teaching me the importance of having two ears and one mouth, along with quite a few other things that I will never forget. I'm thankful for all the times that we get to spend at the lake together. Some of the best lessons and education do not take place inside of four walls. Thank you to Mama and Papa for always being willing to sit on the swing with me and listen to my stories. The good, the bad, the ugly. Just remember that your sweet pea loves you. Next, I want to thank my Aunt Pam for always being there as a second mom and for taking care of me at school, especially for writing the checks to cover expenses when mom would forget to send money. And I'm a high school student, so I'm broke. Thank you to Uncle Robbie G for bringing me and Sophia lunch to school on Fridays. You have been our own personal DoorDash for the past 2 years. Thanks for not telling Mom and Dad. To the aunts, uncles, cousins, thank you for loving me, supporting me, and praying for me. There are so many of you who have helped me through my life. I count each of you as a blessing. Unfortunately, one of the main people I wanted to thank isn't here tonight. At least not physically. My granny Kate. She taught me really important things in life, like how to make red velvet cupcakes and how to love unconditionally. I miss her every single day. In addition to my family, I want to thank the many teachers and administration that have helped me along the way. Especially two of the very best teachers at Isabella High School, Miss Tammy Perrette and Miss Christy Mims. Both of these individuals have always had high expectations for me and cared about me more as a member of their family and not just a student. Thank you to Ms. Pam Bright and Coach Derek Littleton for believing in me and sparking my interest in the game of golf. I also want to thank Mr. Porter, Ms. Ballou, and Ms. Green for helping me to excel in school while also recommending me for post-secondary opportunities. In addition to my current administration, I also want to thank my kindergarten principal, Mr. Larry Raines, who always kept a candy jar on his desk to share with me and let me call him Uncle Raines, even though that we are not related. I never understood why my favorite 5-year-old classmates would be so scared to go see the principal. Who doesn't like candy? Next, I want to thank my best friend and classmate, Sophia Adams, for always being someone I could laugh with, cry with, and count on during all of the craziness of high school. I can't wait to celebrate this milestone with you and to see what great things God has in store for our futures. Finally, I want to thank my parents, Daniel and Sue Ellen Gillen, for putting up with me, giving me all those spankings as a kid. I never understood why you said you wouldn't do it if you didn't love me. But the older I get, the more it makes sense, and the more I love you for it. Dad, thank you for taking me to cheer camp because Mom had to work. You have always done so many things that aren't a typical dad's role. Yet, you just roll with it. I'm kind of jealous I didn't get to go to cheer camp in the Crown Vic, though. You got that one, Emily. Thank you for teaching me that actions speak louder than words. Out of all of our life lessons, this one has helped me out the most. Mom, the best for last. I love you so much. Thank you for being my absolute best friend. I can't thank you enough. Yes, we fuss, fight, and argue, but that only makes our bond grow stronger. Thank you for teaching me if anything is worth doing, it is going to require hard work and effort. You work so hard, and my goal in life is to be at least half the woman that you are. You see, most girls are lucky if they can find that one person to be their ride or die. The person who is willing to do anything for you, even in the face of danger. Yes, life is a highway. You were born with a destination, a purpose, and throughout your life, you are driving down life's highway. Some may choose college, and others may choose the workforce. But either way, each person here tonight holds the keys to his or her success. Just rely on God. I want to let our other younger Mustangs know, like Mary Beth, Emily, Garrett, and Lexi, that high school can be a wild ride with many curves, dips, and bumps, but it is what you make of it. Tonight, I want my classmates to know that this is not the end. This is just the beginning, because
oh, this isn't mine. This is mine. Okay.
Good evening. My name is Braxton Vinson, and thank you all for coming out to celebrate the class 2022 as we embark on a next chapter in our lives. The past 13 years at Isabella have been filled with memories, from our impeccable Motown performance to our Isabellaiad triumphs, and so many more that we could be here all night. But some of these memories would be nothing without the teachers behind them. Even though she would go on maternity leave every time we had her, Miss Mott and her subtle sarcasm were one of the best. Technically, she isn't a teacher, but whether she was on your case about your grades or calling you a turkey, Miss Higgins has always been there for us. And throughout the years, we have formed friendships with each other along the way that makes it feel as though a better way to describe it is family, a dysfunctional one at least. Now that we have reminisced a little, let's focus on what lies ahead. Right now, it seems as though we are all heading in different directions. Some are going to college, some are going straight into the workforce, and some are not quite sure yet. No matter what you're doing, make sure you do not sell yourself short. All of you have the potential to do great things, but if you do not believe that you can accomplish the impossible, then why'd you ever start it? Don't let anyone ever bring you down or set the goals based on their perception. You are a confident, intelligent individual who has the capabilities to achieve your dream. So in the future, whenever I see or hear from you, I want to know all the remarkable things that you have accomplished and what's next. Thank you all, and I can't wait to see what the future holds for you.
Well, my speech is only about 5 pages long. Just kidding. I love you. I'm proud of you. First row, please rise and approach the stage. Sophia Stacy Adams, honors graduate. Arlie Diaz Aguilera, valedictorian, honors graduate. Luca Gianni Biancalana. Kenneth Cameron Bishop. Raymond Jameer Boston III. Destiny Lorelei Brasher, salutatorian, honors graduate. Reese Nicole Brasher. Joshua Richard Connor Bright. Alexandra Bringus Garcia, valedictorian, honors graduate. Anthony Dawson Kleckler. Bianca Ramos Contreras. Brian Dominguez. Caitlin Elizabeth Edwards. Jolyn Elise Jose Espinal. I'm sorry. Tristan Fate Evans. Gabriella Grace Felstead, honors graduate. Abigail Elizabeth Giles. Will the next row of graduates please rise and approach the stage? Braxton Jacob Giles. Danielle Olivia Gilliland, valedictorian, honors graduate. Gael Antonio Gonzalez. Austin Ryan Headley. Brianna Hope Headley. Cadence Lee Headley, salutatorian, honors graduate. Roberto Diane Juarez. Brooklyn Brianna Keenum Giles. Skylar Ray Langford. Logan John Littleton. Timothy Earl McCary Jr. Heather Denise McDonald. Brooke Ann Grace Miller. Carson Danielle Morris. Logan Alexander Murray. April Michelle Norris. Amber Lee Perrett. Will the next row of graduates please rise and approach the stage? Trinity Faith Riley.
Chantel.
Mercedes Chantel Simon.
Yeah.
Lindsay Michaela Sims. Brianna Grace Smith. Savannah Rose Smith. Leanna Elizabeth Tyler. Braxton Lane Vinson, valedictorian, honors graduate. Caleb Charles Washington. Philip Dawson Williams. Jason Dornell Wilson. Kristen Ray Wilson.
All right, graduates, as one chapter closes and you leave the hallowed halls of Isabella High School, a new chapter in this journey that we call life begins. Make sure you surround yourself as you move forward with people who help you be the best version of you and avoid those who don't. Build on your own character, be true to yourself. Be resilient and courageous, not passive, or resigned to a predetermined future that someone else has determined for you. Have a vision of what you want to achieve and go for it. Tonight, as a graduate of the class of 2022, you will always be an alumnus of Isabella High School. If there's ever any way that I or Isabella High School or anyone associated with our school can be of help, we're just a phone call or a visit away. Class of 2022, I want to encourage each of you to remember where you come from. Remember the hard-earned lessons that you've learned here at Isabella. And no matter where life takes you, always be proud to be a Mustang. At this time, I'm going to ask the graduating class of 2022, if you would, to please stand and get ready to throw your caps. I'm going to ask everyone else in the audience, if you would, to please stand and rise. Graduates, if you would, please turn and face the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of 2022. Thank you. Thank all of you for being here with us in God's country tonight. Be safe. It's a great day to be a Mustang.